Hi. The bad big wolf meets Riding Hood Little Red. Something here is amiss, right? Something's not right. So Riding Hood Little Red obviously sounds wrong to us. And you might say it's a known phrase, so that's why it sounds wrong. But the thing is that Elephant Purple also doesn't sound correct. So it's wrong. The thing is that English has prepositive adjectives. That means that the adjectives go before the nouns. Many languages are like this. Bulgarian is like this. Also Russian, Chinese, German, many other languages. Many other languages aren't like this. So the Romance languages, Italian, French, Spanish, but also Arabic and Persian, they aren't like this. They have postpositive adjectives. That means that the adjectives go after the noun. So, of course, in English, the correct words will be Little Red Riding Hood and Purple Elephant, but in Spanish, it will be Caperucita Roja, and in French, it will be Elephant Violet. So, we do have postpositive adjectives in English. For example, if you want to say it sound archaic or poetic, you might say the sounds of ghosts unseen or something, or also in certain borrowed phrases like heir apparent or terra incognita. But also there was another part of the title, Bad Big Wolf. This also doesn't sound correct. Not as wrong as Elephant Purple, but certainly not correct. So the thing is that humans prefer a certain order of adjectives. And that's not only true for English, it's true for most human languages too. So it's described by the handy acronym GSAKPM, and it basically means general opinion, specific opinion, size, shape, age, color, origin, material, and we instinctively want our adjectives to be in that order. GSAKPM, remember that. That's why a big brown wooden spoon sounds correct, and of course other permutations like wooden brown big spoon or brown big wooden spoon makes you sound like a maniac. So there are of course exceptions to GSAKPM, and they are governed by specificity. So the more specific an adjective is, the closer to the noun it goes. So this is true for idioms like last straw is not the actual literal last straw, and if you remove last from straw, it gets completely different meaning. And also certain idiom-like phrases like big spender. It has a literal meaning, but it's also a known phrase. So that's a big evil man, but an evil big spender. If you were paying attention, however, you would have noticed that big bad wolf violates GSAKPM. So bad is opinion, and big is size. It should be bad big wolf. The thing is that we also have this thing called ablaut reduplication. And that means that certain orders of vowels sound nice to us. So I-A-O is true for English. So that's why in English we have hip-hop and not hop-hip, and tit for tat and not tat for tit. Well, sometimes we do have tat for tit, but that's another story. And now we have some small interlude. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. So prepare your tomatoes, because I'll be talking about C++. Anyone here a C++ programmer? Anyone here a C++ programmer? No? 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 Oh, one hand over there. Okay, so in C++ we have this thing int. It's an integer variable. We can have it an unsigned integer variable like this, and then a constant integer variable like this. But is anyone here familiar with the West Coast-East Coast rivalry in American hip-hop? Sure, we all know this. Well, in C++, we have this West Coast-East Coast rivalry. So both are valid, but where to put the const is actually a matter of discussion. Bike sharing, but still a very big discussion, especially in open source circles, and many open source projects are converting from one to the other. So, and int const, which is east const, is basically winning. But English is the lingua franca of software engineering, which is, I don't know, ironic, because lingua franca means French language in Italian. So, and programming languages are still made for human beings. And int is noun, unsigned int is an idiom-like phrase, so const int and const unsigned int would be correct. This is correct English, West const. And this, of course, is incomprehensible gibberish. What is this? Come on. So And some people might say that in this case, you might think that int is an adjective and const is a noun, but that's not true. We have const methods in C++. So unless you're French or Shakespearean, West Coast is the way to go. West Coast for C++. Thank you, everyone.